listen,
listen,
let your heart keep sinking,
listen,
listen,
to his constant speaking,
listen,
listen,
to the Spirit calling you, listen,
listen,
to his inspiration,
listen,
listen, to his invitation,
listen,
in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us acknowledge our faults and our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Today the church remembers the feast of Saint Agatha, Virgin and Martyr. May the Virgin Martyr, Saint Agatha, implore your passion for us, O Lord, for she found favor with you by the courage of her martyrdom and the merit of her chastity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. King David said to Joab and to the senior army officers who were with him, "Now go throughout the tribes of Israel from Dan to Beersheba and take a census of the people. I wish to know the size of the population." Joab gave the king the figures of the census of the people. Israel numbered 800,000 armed men capable of drawing swords, and Judah 500,000 men. But afterwards, King David's heart misgave him for having taken a censor of the people. "I have committed a grave sin," David said to the Lord. "But now, Lord, I beg you to forgive your servant for this fault. I have been very foolish." But when David got up the next morning, the following message had come from the Lord to the prophet Dan, through the prophet Gad, David's seers, "Go and say to David, the Lord says this, I offer you three things. Choose one of them for me to do to you." So Gad went to David and told him, "Are 3 years of famine to come on you in your country?" he said. "Or will you flee for 3 months before your pursuing enemy? Or would you rather have 3 days pestilence in your country? Now think and decide how I am to answer him who sends me." David said to Gad, "This is a hard choice, but let us rather fall into the power of the Lord, since his mercy is great, and not into the power of man." So David chose pestilence. It was a time of the wheat harvest. The Lord sent a pestilence on Israel from the morning till the time appointed, and plague ravaged the people, and from Dan to Beersheba, 70,000 men of them died. The angel stretched out his hand towards Jerusalem to destroy it, but the Lord thought better of this evil. And he said to the angel who was destroying the people, "Enough, now withdraw your hand." The angel of the Lord was besides the threshing floor of around the Jebusites. When David saw the angel who was ravaging the people, he spoke to the Lord. "It was I who sinned," he said. "I who did this wicked thing. But this flock, what they have done, let your hand lie heavy on me then and on my family." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: Forgive, Lord, the guilt of my sins. Kindly repeat.
Forgive, Lord, the guilt of my sins.
Happy the man whose offense is forgiven, whose sin is remitted. Oh, happy the man to whom the Lord imputes no guilt, in whose spirit is no guilt. Response:
Forgive, Lord, the guilt of my sin.
But now I have acknowledged my sins. My guilt I did not hide. I said, "I confess my offense to the Lord." And you, Lord, have forgiven the guilt of my sin. Response:
Forgive, Lord, the guilt of my sin.
So let every good man pray to you in the time of need. The floods of water may reach high, but him they shall not reach. Response:
Forgive, Lord, the guilt of my sin.
You are my hiding place, O Lord. You save me from distress. You surround me with cries of deliverance. Response:
Forgive, Lord, the guilt of my sins.
Kindly rise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went to his hometown, and his disciples accompanied him. With the coming of the Sabbath, he began teaching in the synagogue, and most were astonished when they heard him. They said, "Where did the man get all this? What is this wisdom that has been granted him, and these miracles that are worked through him? This is the carpenter, surely the son of Mary, the brother of James and Joseph and Jude and Simon. His sisters too, are they not here with us?" And they would not accept him. And Jesus said to them, "A prophet is only despised in his own country, among his own relations, and in his own house. And he could work no miracle there, though he cured a few sick people by laying his hands on them." He was amazed at their lack of faith. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We see a few striking words in the Gospel of today. Firstly, we see most of them were astonished when they heard him. This is the crowd that accompanies Jesus, and then they were astonished. when they hear him, because he was speaking with authority. He was speaking what he was reflecting and praying upon. We also, when we do good works, people do appreciate us. That shows that this work has gained fruit. Sometimes we may do it alone, without the help of God. And that is where we falter. We rely on our own strengths. We rely on our own abilities, forgetting that these abilities or these strengths are gifts given by God Himself. Secondly, it's a valley moment for Jesus. Okay, it's valley in the sense of he's deep in the valley, okay, in the dark, because these people also question him. And therefore he replies, a prophet is only despised in his own country. He does all this good, but yet people doubt him. People put a question mark in their mind regarding him. And therefore it is important that to note that Jesus, who is also suffering because the others are rejecting him, comes out and wishes that these people stop, they pray for him, etc. And lastly, he was going to, as he cured few sick people, he was amazed by their lack of faith. Sometimes even we lack faith. We lack the trust in Jesus. Let us build this trust in Jesus. Let us build this faith in Jesus. It is very important not just to do what we like, but to do what the Lord wants to do in and through us. We can be His instruments. We can be the pencil in His hand, so that He writes in and through us the chapter of our life. Amen. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Let us pray. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, His resurrection we confess with living faith, and His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by a cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Philip Neri, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await a blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance to your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. Hymn number 290 on page 91. 290, page 91.